Okay, so now we will have a look at the code of this very simple model that will designed to show the interaction intensity between nodes of a network by applying a gravitational model. So we start with the declaration of the variable mass, because it's an attribute of every turtle in the model, and this is the setup function. So as you see, you start by clearing all the world of NetLogo, and you create a number of turtles defined by this slider NB nodes. And for each turtle that you create, you put its color to a random number between in principle 5 and 135. This line will should generate an exponential distribution of mean mass mean. Mass mean is defined here in this slider. So basically, you take a random number between 0 and 1. You apply this formula, and with the parameter lambda defined here, you obtain an exponential distribution of parameter lambda. I multiply by the mass mean to have an exponential distribution of mean and mass mean. Then the turtles are placed at random in the world of NetLogo, and I apply the logarithm of the mass to the size of the nodes in order to have nodes that are not too big for the visualization. I set the shape of the turtles to be a circle, and I initialize my tick counter. Okay, so that is for setup function that you can see in action here. Okay, second function, the function link with close. The function link with close will connect the turtles that are at a distance between this minimum distance and this maximum distance. If I increase the maximum distance, a lot of links are created. And if I decrease the maximal distance, fewer links are created. So, how does this function work? We start by removing every link, because the former link should be defined for previous values of the parameters dmin and dmax. Then we ask the turtles to ask the other turtle to compute the distance with myself. So myself is the first calling turtle, so one turtle asks every other turtle to compute the distance with him. So the function distance computes the distance between one turtle, the turtle who is currently asking to do something, and myself, which is the original turtle. And if this distance is between dmax and dmin, we just ask to create a link with myself, myself being the original turtle here. And that's it. This is what creates the link with the neighbors. This is the function that display the gravitational interaction flows. It simply asks all the links to compute the flow between T1 and T2. T1 and T2 are two turtles that are the extremities of each link. So when I ask links to declare the variable T1 to be end1, end1 is a built-in variable for links that is simply the extremity of the link, as you can see here in the documentation. So I declare the two turtles, one extremity and one the other extremity and T2, and I ask the function compute flow to compute the flow between T1 and T2. This function is declared elsewhere in the code. Here, yeah. So It takes two arguments, one total t1, the other total t2. It declares the distance to be 0. It asks the first total to compute the distance with the other total. It takes the mass of t1. This should be t1. Yeah. And t2, yeah. And then the flux is the product of k times m1 times m2 divided by the distance to the power dk. And then it reports the flux, the flow that exists between these two totals. Okay, so when I click on this function, every node that is superior to every flow of interaction between two nodes that is superior to one is displayed in orange, as you can see in the last part of the code of show flow function. So we have just asked to compute the flow between total t1 and t2, and if the flux is superior to 1, you set the color of the link to orange, and you adapt the thickness, so the size of the link, to be equal to the logarithm of the flow, plus a little constant in case you have null masses, zero masses. You can take the logarithm of 0, so we add a little constant so that the function doesn't produce an error. Okay, I will stop here for this video to remain short, and in the following video we will see the rest of the code, notably the interaction step function. Thank you.